हेलो गाइस, वेलकम ऑल टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल। होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग ग्रेट।
इन दिस वीडियो वील टॉक अबाउट फ्यू बेसिक पॉइंट दैट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सेल्फ डिफेंस एंड व्हाट आर डिफरेंट मूव्स दैट यू कैन यूज ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम। दिस इज समथिंग दैट एवरी वन नीड टू नो, स्पेशली फॉर गर्ल्स। सो नाउ लेट्स मूव टूवर्ड अवर वीडियो। Here I'm explaining that what are different moves or tricks that you can use if someone has hold your neck or choke your neck with their double hand. In this situation, most people try to loosen their grip by just applying pressure on the arms of an attacker, which is just a waste of time. Like you can see, I'm holding her neck, but it's not easy for her to get out of the situation. Even situation become worse for her if she is trying such kind of stupid things here. Now here I would like to remind you basic rule that we apply if someone have hold your wrist. At that time, if you try to lift your hand up and apply pressure, then you can't loosen the grip. So now, as you can see, she is holding my hand. So if I want to get out of the situation, then I need to pressure the weakest portion of her grip. As you can see, this is the strongest portion because there she has four fingers, and the weakest portion is where she has a single thumb. So if we apply pressure in the direction of thumb, so it's easy for everyone to get out of the grip. So same case with the neck choke situation. First you need to observe the grip. So if I am applying pressure with my thumb and try to choke her neck, then she have to apply pressure toward the direction of the thumb. First thing that she need to do, just tighten her neck muscles and squeeze her neck. Then apply pressure in downward direction toward thumb, go down and get away. This is life threatening situation. So first thought that should come in your mind should be to run away from the situation, because if you try to fight with a person who is way stronger than you, then this is just a stupidity. Again, if I try to loosen her grip by just applying pressure on her arms, then this is not gonna work. So I'll do squeeze my neck muscles, go down and run away. And all I need to do within 5 seconds, because you can't survive neck choke for more than 5 seconds. What are another things that we can do here? So as you can observe, the first major drawback here is that the person is in my range. I can lift my knee up and hit on his groin part. But the most important thing, whenever you are hitting someone on his private part or groin area, your attack should be accurate. It should have perfect effect, because if you are not gonna to hit someone properly, then it may make someone more aggressive and the situation can be worsened for you. And there are some another people like drunken guy, drug addict, and those people have different intensity of pain whenever you are hitting them on any part. So you may get different kind of reactions from different people. So now let's differentiate between a groin attack of male and female. So whenever we are talking about female, you need to hit between the legs of a female and at a groin portion and try to get a thrust kick here instead of a knee attack, because due to different location, we can say it's not gonna work for female to give a knee attack. So better to give a thrust kick between the legs to get a best impact. And in case of a male, their genital organ, or we can say reproductive organs, are exposed. So it's easy for anybody to hit them, and you can easily hit them with your knee attack and push kick. So there is difference between location of male and female genitalia. That's why there is different angle, different attacks that you need to use whenever you are fighting with a male and female attacker, that you need to keep in mind. And whenever you are attacking someone with a kick or any move, be accurate, be fast, be alert. And if you're gonna to miss that attack, then be ready for the next move, because you need to keep on acting simultaneously and you don't have time to waste. Now hit. Whenever person get disbalanced, just use that time and run away from that situation. That's all for today's video. Hope there would be some messages or any information that would be useful to you. So do share it with others. If you are new here, so do subscribe my channel. now and press that bell icon so that you will get notification for upcoming videos. You can follow me on Instagram. My Insta ID is amandeep.rajput.75. See you soon in the next video. Bye bye.